game between Skåne Fotboll, Faro and Mighty Legions Academy is over. It's Skåne who takes 3 points and win with 1-0 here in Boys 70. We're heading over for the last game here at Puma Arena, and it's the Puma Trophy Group 3. And the game between AIK FF from Sweden and Academia Radu Rebea from Romania. Vi ska oss göra redo för sista matchen här på Puma Arena, och det är den sista gruppspelsmatchen i Puma Trophy Grupp 3. Det är svenska AIK FF som tar sig an rumänska Academia Radu Rebea. Det är väldigt mycket folk på ingång här till Puma Arena på Heden 4. Så vi ber som sitter på läktarna just nu att trycka ihop lite, så vi får så mycket folk som möjligt på läktarna. Ready to start the next game here at Puma Arena. It's the Puma Trophy Group 3. In the red shirts from Moldavia, give it up for Academia Radu Rebea. Och I svarta tröjor från Sverige, AIK FF. We also welcome our new referee and audience to Puma Arena. Thank you.
Welcome everybody, it's time for a big game. It's a Boys 17 Elite category here at Puma Arena in central Gothenburg. Here then, we have the Moldavian team, Rado Rebeja in red, and the Swedish team, AIK, in black, yellow and white. It's going to be an interesting game. AIK sits in top of their group, while the Moldavian team is placed third. And if they take 3 points here, they have a chance to go through to the A playoffs, I should say. They have Mjällby IF in front of them, who took 3 points today against Tikitaka International, the team from Nigeria. It was a free 3 points. It was a walkover from the Nigerian side due to the circumstances they have faced during this tournament. We will see if the Moldavian team can take 3 points there. AIK has been very, very strong throughout the tournament. Won their two group games. First against Oh my god, I glömde klicka på play. A little bit of a delay here. The Moldavian team, Akademia Rado Rebeja, took the lead after just a few minutes in the first half against the Swedish team AIK FF. Number 7, Artur Sprinshaw, with a fine goal. And it's a big game for the Moldavian team, who plays in red. They have the chance to move on up in their group and go through to the A playoffs if they get 3 points here and a few goals. They have Mjällby IF, who got 3 points off Tikitaka earlier today by walkover, and they sit right now in second place. It's going to be a battle of the two who goes to the A playoffs. AIK is already done. They're going to do the playoffs after two wins. First one, Tikitaka on Monday.
Nu är det igen.
Team Rado Rebeja, who plays in red, they take on the Swedish team AIK FF, who plays in black and white. Big game for the Moldavians. If they
Thank you.
A lot of ball for AIK the last few minutes. It was a pretty offensive start from Rado Ribeira. Has backed down a little bit as AIK has worked their way in to the game. Haven't had a lot of attacks so far, Swedish team. Free kick, have a Moldavian player in the grass. Ball is back in play. Chance for a counter-attack here. It's a great tackle. Suleiman, number 14 in AIK, gets the free kick, and then there's a little bit of a brawl there against two players, but nothing serious. Abdullah. Nice pass. Could get the ball into the box. Cutback is blocked. And here's another chance for a counter attack. Great done by Gabi Söder, number 3, center back. Number 17 gets the cross in, goes long. A bit too long, and there's going to be a throw in for AIK. See if you could see Asari, number 11. I can get a hand on this ball. Not that time. Haven't seen a lot of him yet. There hasn't been a lot of attacks from the Swedish side either. So when he gets the ball, it's possible it could get dangerous. We've seen it so fast. He's not very small either. Games they have played. It's going to be a corner kick for Rebea. Header away from the center back. To work on it. He gets the shot, and look at that goal! What a wonderful goal from number 11 in AIK, Jonah Kusiastare. I told you just a minute ago, he hasn't shown his true colors yet, but when he gets the ball, it's dangerous. Equalized, it's 1-1. The 13th minute of play. Goal number 4 for number 11, Jonah Kusiasare. Scored 2 in the first game against Tiki Taka. Scored 1 yesterday against Mjällby AIF. Two balls on the field. Gonna have a little drop down here. So fast, number 11. Was far behind the Moldavian player. Got those long steps. Offside. for Sika. Goalkeeper comes out, takes the battle with Kusiasari, who wants to throw in. Couldn't really get the shot from that angle. Kusiasari. Abdullah. Here we have the captain, number 8 for Aiko. Smajic. From Suleiman, trying to find Christian Sika, gets another shot maybe. That's not, and that's gonna be a free kick. No question about it. And number 16, Abdullah's gonna get a little bit of a warning from the referee. Gets away without a yellow card. Score for Radrebejo. What can he do? Can he get past Nildén? Pass it on to Nico Fortuna. Great press work from Ratu. Can't get the ball though. Nico crosses it over to Nikita. So good one-on-one. Here comes the ball into the box, and there's a shot blocked by Gabriel Söder. And it's going to be a corner for Radrebeja. Corner goes to the far post. Nothing more than a goal kick. So, Academia Radrebeja, the Moldavian team, lost their first game Monday against Mjölby IF with 3-2. Took a win against Tiki Taka. You only had 9 players available for the second round. As their captain got a red card against AIK in the first group game. Right now, they sit third in the table of Group 3 with 3 points. 3 points here is a must if they're going to have a chance to go through to the playoffs. Had a good start to the first half with a quick goal from number 7, Artur. It's Nico Fortuna, chased by Rathud. Play the pass back. It's very nice to Leon Nildén. It's a ball for Nikita. Nice first touch. Gets the ball in. There's the AIK player on the line. Could be more here for the Moldavian team. It's a bit tight. Can he get it before the line? He does not. It's going to be a kick for the goalie. So Mjölby is now second in the table with 6 points, level with AIK. Fewer goals, they got 3 points today against Tiki Taka International team from Nigeria, who pretty much pulled out. They left a walkover because of the circumstances. They only have 10 players. They did play a friendly game today at SKF Arena. Game that Tiki Taka won actually with 2-0. Great for the Nigerian team to take a win in the group stages, even though they're not going to go to the playoffs. Balance opens up for Kawa Suleiman. Ball ends up with Jonah Kusiasare. Ah, so good. Oh, the first touch is not that good from Neo Lindén. Slips away from him. Great little flick there. The ball into the middle is good. Gets past the defender, not the second one. Ayubadulle with a little trick. We have Sika fighting. It's a tough challenge. Gets the free kick. Number 9 in AIK was a bit of a play laying down there from Davin player. That resulted in a free kick. Can he keep it in play? He does get a big push. And is given a free kick. And first yellow card of the game goes to number 6 in AIK, Leon Nildén. Free kick pretty far away from the box. It's Nico Fortuna, the right back, who's gonna take it. Takes it quickly. One on one with Jonah Kusiasare. Gets through. Cutback is pretty good, but none other than a Michael defender in the way. Smudge is taking a bit too long, but gets a tackle in. It's long ball for Sika. Oh, there's a little bit of a miscommunication there between the defender and the goalkeeper. Another one! Let's see if the players are okay. Christopher Sika on the ground. Sits up for now. Doesn't look like it's going to be a problem for him to continue, but those battles in the air are pretty scary. You never really know how they land. But it's okay. I think it was a bit of a frustration there amongst the players as well. So we have about a little less than 10 minutes left to play the first half. It's score is 1-1. See if a team can take the lead before we hit the 30-minute mark. Challenge. Nikita goes winning out of that one. Gets a free kick. Little bit up, further up in the field from the last one that was from the other side. Let's see if this free kick can result in something a little bit more dangerous than the last one. Big gather around the penalty mark. Here comes the free kick. Goes to the middle, headed away. Here comes the shot from Nico Fortuna. Goes high up. Not the easiest shot, but why not? You never know. So the elimination rounds start tomorrow, Thursday. We're gonna have to wait and see who's gonna meet who. It's gonna be some interesting games, some very good teams from the other groups. There are six groups for boys 17 elite category who plays for the Puma Trophy. We saw earlier today one of the big favorites, Right to Dream, take a pretty convincing win against Elfsborg just before this game. That's a team that you don't want to meet. You can take them in the final, but you don't want to meet them in the round of 16 or quarterfinals or semifinals. They're playing really, really good. Jonah Kusia started with a flick, really good. Here's a ball for Rathud. Has Sika in the middle. Comes to me, doesn't get the ball. Now there's two balls on the field. Number nine kicks it off. Nikita has two opponents against him. Gets some help. Video puts it out left for Nikita. A little fumble there, gives away a throw in. To Neil Diem. Back to Rathud. Abdullah, what can he do? Goes for a long ball with the zero address. Wasn't even close to a teammate. Throw to Nildiam, left winger. Can't get control of the ball.
It's a bit of a
good chance here for
hard pass there.
Kusiasari, who's it's very strong. Held back, and of course it's going to be a free kick. Some words from the defender. Could have been a yellow card there. I mean, he was hugging him pretty tight. About 3 minutes left in the first half. The score is equal, 1-1. It's getting a bit chilly here in Gothenburg. The wind has picked up a little bit. The sun is... covered by clouds. We are happy as long as we don't have any rain. 3 minutes was not that long. 30 minutes are up, and we are back shortly with the second half between Tavarebeya and Oikov.
Detta är alltså sista matchen här på Puma Arena för idag innan vi kör igång slutspelet imorgon. We'll be right back. Bosse på folk, du är redo att köra igång andra halvleken mellan AIK FF och Academia Radio Rebea.
Having some problems with the sound at the moment. Just guys for a minute, but we're back up. As the locals so far in the second half. So it's still 1-1 against IQ. I think three goals are a must here for the that will go through to the playoffs starts tomorrow. First in the top of the table and go through WIF since second. 3 points today. We walk over is to protect them. I'm actually in the stands watching on to see if they're going to play a playoffs. And is it going to be the Davian team? Rebella. I'm going to be a corner here for another Rebella. Goes to the first post, it's really good. There's going to be a free kick for Captain. Seth does a bit of a blow to the head. Referee is calling in for some assistance. As it could be a bit serious, we'll find out in a minute. We can continue to play 6 up at least, which is good. He's up on his feet, ready to continue the game. Gets a little handshake from his opponent. Chaser, it's off. Let's get through in them. It's fucking pain. It's late. Hard work in a machine. 15 magnets. Busted to like one. It's been really good in the game so far. Delivered long ball for Jonah Kusasar. Great ball control for number 11. Starting to play a little bit. A little bit of a thought out pass there from Gabriel Söder. Top in Aiko's favor, anyways. Jonah Kusasar, can he hold off his opponent? In video instead, captain for Rebella. About 20 minutes to go. The second half. Still a lot of time for to try and get all 3 points. Chance for attack here. Keep the eyes on the red. Goes for the shot instead. It's not that bad. It's the target. But outside. Down be something here for Devin to try to get the ball into his teammate. He gets the corner. First, close the header, looked pretty dangerous, but a few meters off the post. Long ball. Too long for Suleiman on the right wing. And a free kick. Davidson. Bit further back. He's going to take the corner. The low one. Oh, I could play around. Bit of a waste there. The 26. We got the bump there, and it opens up for a little bit, but can't get control of the ball. Gets a yellow card, left tackle, Neil Lindian. Got another player laying down. So yeah, gotten hurt in the upfield. His teammates just wants him to get off the field. I mean, every minute counts now. Be a playoff A here for the leading team. Danilo Andresio, number 23, sorry, helped his teammate off. No difference. It's crucial. Yeah, another free kick. Another one too many in the Moldavian team. Silencio has to step out. Okay, there you go. a lot of free kicks in this game. The nicest play amongst these teams. Another one. Pretty decent position. Another Abella. Big gather. Players ready to run in. Goes for the back post. Away by Kostiasari. Doesn't leave the box. He's rewarded with a free kick. Not a lot of space to carry with the players. Probably has two players against him. He has blown his whistle. Not sure why. He's looking across the field. That was about the ballsy play once again. Cross ball to Seattle Tig. Gets it under control. 16 gets the on. Can't keep his balance. Great ball for Nikolai. Goalkeeper is out far, but he can't get the ball on target. It's a very good chance there for Rubea. A tough angle. Forward. Still a good chance. So the misses. Attacks are not very long. And goes for both sides. Just a bit too many mistakes. Whatever man can go and get some proper attacks. Right now it just goes back and forth. Thank you. less than 10 minutes ago of the second half between RKFF and Rebea. The score is still 1-1 after two goals in the second half. First half, I should say, we haven't seen any goal scoring. Second half, haven't seen any shots on target either. Yes, I am. Shot in here, looking for an opportunity with his right foot. Yeah. Salema can get it back. Get a cut back here, cuts over, Yaratig. Gets the shot, great save! And then we have Luna Kutsi Asmara with the brace. And Oiko takes the lead. With the support, and it's pretty obvious. And the mobility is still 2-1 to Oiko. A mess in front of goal, but they couldn't get the ball away. And just had a very distinctive shot. Next, his fifth goal of the tournament.
Och i två i matchen, han gör sitt andra mål. Han är Jona Kusi Asare.
Very good for. Card for number 17. Support tackling thing was for shit behavior. Coming in is a dog. With the ball. That did. On the team link. Like that one-on-one challenge. Thank you. push it from Radrubel in the end goal. Now there's a bit of a fight amongst the players. Especially searching his pocket to put the yellow card away. There's a bit of a dispute there between Mingrains and his largest, Michael. And the team, second team. Which is Roiko. Ball gets to throw him. With a flick, finds a way to get a tick, can't get control of the ball. Nice little man, quick feet from number 20. And the other, Munoz, has a touch. This is how he wins it back. Yeah, Tig, to the 16th Gustafsson. Captain. No such a dribble. They get the shot. It's a good save on the line. Yes. Put the ball back in the box. Lindén. It's Kusiasari. Get the header in, but flag is up and it's offside. The header wasn't that good anyway. A bit out of position. Back against the goal. Munoz. Ball back. With you. Getting very close to the hour mark. The end of the second half. Looks like they're going for another win. If that's the case, it's going to be 3 out of 3 in the group stages. We have 9 points possible. And if this is the end result, they're going to be joined by Mjällby IF into the elimination round that starts tomorrow, the A playoffs. Is your fire? Chance for Munoz, but he's offside. The first touch was really, really, really good. On the right side of the line. And there goes the whistle. The game is over. Bernie Oracle wins with 2 goals to 1. the breakdown number 11.
Thank you. I love you.